Okay.
So welcome back to what is it now? Like episode 71 of the Fortnite Mythbusters. Yesterday, I put out a poll asking whether or not I should post this video, and a whole ton of you guys really wanted another Mythbusters episode, so here it is. Just like always though, I am going to set a like goal on today's video, so at any point, if you do enjoy today's episode of the Fortnite Mythbusters, feel free to leave a like. Let's see if we could smash 15,000 likes. That would be greatly appreciated. Also, just like always, if you do have a myth you would like me to test in the next or future episodes of the Fortnite Mythbusters, make sure to go down in the comment section down below and drop a comment of a unique myth for a pretty good chance to be featured. Also, if you guys don't know already, at 500,000 subscribers, I will be doing a face reveal, so if you do enjoy my videos and you would like to see more by me, feel free to subscribe and also turn on those post notifications to never miss another Fortnite Mythbusters episode. Also, guys, if you do want to talk to me one-on-one, I will be responding to as many DMs as I get on my Instagram, so feel free to drop me a follow. But without further ado, let's get right on into episode 71 of the Fortnite Mythbusters. Going straight into the first myth is, will a shield bubble protect you from zombies if they try to damage you through the shield bubble's walls? Recently, we've been testing so many myths revolving around the shield bubble, and this is definitely one of my favorites and something that might actually help you in game. With no doubt about it, running around Retail Road, these zombies are a total pain and they can do a lot of damage to you if you do stand still for literally only 1 second. Surprisingly, when I did try this out, the zombies, they threw like these balls. I honestly have no clue what those are called, but anyways, when they threw those and the barrier of the shield bubble was in between me and the zombie, the bubble actually protected you and you wouldn't take any damage from that. This also goes for if the zombie is inside of the bubble and you are on the outside, no matter what, if any of, I guess, their projectiles do hit the barrier of the bubble, it won't do any damage to you, which is a good thing to know. Going into the next myth is, if you have the hop rock effect from the old stadium and go to the Loot Lake zone, will you jump twice as high? Now, Loot Lake is definitely an interesting place to fight at because within, I guess, the zone of Loot Lake, you have this weird jump effect where you can jump about like 3 to 4 walls high, which obviously changes up the gameplay quite a bit. Similar to the Loot Lake zones, there are these crystals that are currently at the old soccer stadium, and you can actually consume one of these crystals and it will give you the anti-gravity, the little bit of a jump height effect. So if you do take one of these and you head straight on over to the Loot Lake zone, will you be able to jump maybe even like twice as high as normal? To my surprise, you literally float in midair whenever you do consume one of these, I guess, energy crystals, and you do go inside of the Loot Lake zone. You try and jump and it literally floats you all the way up to the zone, and then of course you'll go through the zone and then you'll fall back down, and you basically just float while you're inside of Loot Lake, which is pretty cool, I'm not gonna lie. Unfortunately though, with you being able to fly around Loot Lake and such, it makes it extremely hard to manage your way around there, and it's kind of impossible to go down unless you go outside of the zone. Going straight into the next myth is, will a zap trap attach to a wall in Tilted Town? If so, can you replace a door with the zap trap and possibly block people inside of their own buildings? The special thing about Tilted Town is that you are not able to place or destroy literally anything inside of there, so if you do throw a zap trap and it does replace the wall, which of course is a door, you could probably trap players inside of their own buildings, which makes it so they could never leave and end up dying to the zone. When I first tested this out, surprisingly the zap trap actually replaced a regular wall inside of Tilted Town. I then went over to a door and even a window, but every time I threw down the zap trap on one of those, the walls, they totally disappeared. They weren't even there. The zap trap seems to be like one of the only ways you could actually destroy walls inside of Tilted Town. As of right now though, I'm honestly not sure if it's kind of like a 50-50 chance or if I just got lucky on that first throw, but I can't seem to get another zap trap to replace a door or even a window. Going into the next myth is, does the shield bubble on the hoverboard trick work for other vehicles as well? Now, I'm not gonna bore you through this entire myth, but there is one key point which I do want to touch on. So basically, for the quick answer, it works on every single vehicle. You can throw a shield bubble on a quad launcher, even a baller, and even a plane, and the shield bubble will stick to it and the shield will go around with you. What's interesting though is when the shield bubble is actually on top of a baller and you do try and grapple around, the grapple will not go through the shield bubble's walls, which makes it pretty hard to manage your way around while inside of a baller. So if the ballers ever do get unvaulted, which I kind of hope they do, they were a very good way of transportation around the map, you might want to keep this in mind. You might not want to throw a shield bubble because it will be extremely difficult to grapple onto things and fling yourself across the map. Going into the next myth is, do rockets bounce off Kevin the Cube on the main island similar to how they bounce off the creative cubes? Now, if you don't watch the Mythbusters episodes, or maybe this is even your first, hopefully first of many, we found out that if you do spawn in the Kevin the Cube gallery in creative mode and shoot rockets at it, the rockets will literally bounce off of it, and you could basically do a lot of really cool stuff with this. Unfortunately, on the main island, Kevin the cube that we know currently holding up the island of Loot Lake, it doesn't act the exact same way. I mean, you try and shoot a rocket at this, firstly, the wing pushes the rockets out of the way, which makes it extremely difficult to directly hit Kevin the Cube, but the chance that you do hit the cube with your rocket, unfortunately, they will not bounce off. They will just explode on impact, which, it's kind of a bummer, I'm not gonna lie. Fortnite, you definitely disappointed me with this one. I mean, this is one of the most fun things to do in creative mode, and I guess you can't do it even on the main island. Just the rockets, they just get blown away, which makes this pretty difficult to do literally anything with this cube. Going into the next myth is, can you pickaxe to break a shield bubble in Tilted Town? Now, if you don't know already, a regular shield bubble, when you throw it down on the ground, it has its own hitbox, which allows it to stick onto ballers, planes, and even the hoverboard. So will you be able to break this inside of Tilted Town, since Tilted Town's special thing is nothing is able to be placed or even destroyed? I tried this myth out in Tilted Town, and luckily I found a shield bubble pretty quickly. I thought that was going to be pretty difficult to do, I'm not going to lie, and surprisingly, you are able to pickaxe it to break it, which totally disproves the entire thing about Tilted Town. You are actually able to pickaxe to break a couple of things. Not only were you able to pickaxe to break the shield bubble, you were actually able to shoot it, and that will also do damage to the shield bubble and end up breaking it as well. I guess this is good to know, but of course, in game, when you are fighting someone, you really aren't focusing on the shield bubble. It kind of benefits both parties in their own special ways. Going into the next myth is, if you place a wall half in and half out of the Pandora area, will half of the wall have that special texture, which a lot of us know from Borderlands? Speaking of Borderlands coming out soon, let me know if you guys would like to see a Borderlands Mythbusters series here on the channel. I mean, of course, I will still be doing the Fortnite Mythbusters, but I thought since the new game's coming out that I will be personally playing quite a bit, would you guys like to see some content on there as well? When I did try this out, it's pretty difficult to see the barrier, I'm not gonna lie, so it was hard to find the exact point that I do need to place the wall, but I'm pretty sure I nailed it, and surprisingly, you aren't able to have that texture when you're outside of the barrier. But of course, right when you pass that line, right when you do enter Pandora, you will be able to see the texture that we all love on the wall. Another weird thing, I don't know if it's just creative mode, but the map was glitched. The map would not let me zoom out. It only showed Pandora's area, and that's it whenever I did enter. But as soon as I walked outside of it, I was able to see the entire map, which I was kind of confused about. Jumping straight into the next myth is, can you drop from max height and be saved if you are dropped close to the meteor? Now, this is a pretty simple myth, so I'm not gonna let it take up too much time, but it surprisingly got like 600, 700 likes on one of the previous Mythbuster videos. In creative mode, I cranked those 90s all the way up to the build limit, I then jumped off pretty close to the meteor, and at first I was falling extremely fast up until I got pretty close to the meteor, which obviously protected me from taking any sort of fall damage, which it's a good thing to know if you are in the middle of the game and you do have a build fight over the meteor. This has definitely opened up my mind though. I do have a few tactics that I might try out in game because of this sole reason. Going into the last and final myth, this myth is, what happens when you are rebooted with Junkrift debris on top of the reboot van? This was actually a really, really good myth because, of course, you are not able to build anywhere near the reboot van as well. Whenever you do throw a Junkrift, one of the falling objects, they turn into an actual object in game, which allows you to farm it up. I tried this a couple of times, and the two times we did try it, it would just push you away from the vehicle. I mean, you would either spawn on top of the van or even a little bit to the side. You would never spawn inside of the actual debris itself. But surprisingly, one time when I spawned myself and my friend rebooted me, I was actually stuck inside of the police car, which was halfway through the van, and I was infinitely gliding. I was able to pull my glider, and I would infinitely just glide around. I was able to just skydive, freefall, literally anything I did. And what was weird is it was impossible to get outside of this. I was never able to move until the debris itself was destroyed. Anyways, that's gonna wrap it up for today's video. I hope you have enjoyed. If you have, make sure to leave a like. Also, subscribe if you are new to the channel. If you do have a myth you would like me to test in the next or future Mythbuster episodes, make sure to go down in the comment section down below and drop a comment of that myth for a pretty good chance to be featured. And I will see you guys next time.